Hi guys, it's Zizi here from Backgammon Coaching, and today we are here with the position of the day number 7. We are 51 pips up, we have to play double ones as black. Pause the video if you want to think about it, as I'm going to share the explanation. Again, let's look at the answer right away, so we can better discuss and understand what's going on. So, obviously, we are hitting here, so that's 2. Then we've got 2 options. Either play, well, few options, not just 2 options. Either we can just make the 13 points. Seems safe, huh? Well, not that, not really. He's just gonna enter 4 something. What's our plan now? I mean, are we going to roll something like 3-2, 4-2, 4-1? Name any number which is not a 10 or 11. I mean, this is what's going to happen every single time. We are going to get trapped every single time. Not talking about 4-3, which leaves quadruple shot. I don't even know how that's called. This is what's going to happen every single time when we make the 13 point. This is very, very crucial to see over the board, as even those automatic moves, you may consider it automatic move, but really, just stop by before you press the clock. Just look what's really gonna happen, you know? It's not safe. This is not safe. He's just gonna enter anywhere. Most of the time, even if he doesn't enter, like, we still have to leave those shots. So this game, unless we roll double sixes, of course, we cannot avoid not leaving a shot. So we start with a hit, and we know that we cannot make the 13 point. What we do want to do is spread those checkers, get closer to board, as well as minimize numbers, so it's easier to play out when he comes in. So let's again look at the position. This is a position, right? See the answer, how close it will be. So we hit, we decided on a hit. Then, well, as we said, we wanna get closer as he is going to enter. So yes, we are leaving a shot, either here or here, but well, I mean, it's worth the risk. We will be forced to leave a shot anyways. So our idea is to maximize our chances to get home and balance it with leaving shots. As we could already see the result, those 2 plays, which where to put the checker, they are and they will be pretty close, as the idea is always, always, always just to get closer to home, or, well, not leave shots at all, except maybe double fours. But stay spread, because once you stay spread, whatever you play, he is gonna enter. But, well, you've got some great numbers. You can roll something like 6-5, 5-4, 4-3. Well, my favorite move was this, since we leave some shots, 6-5, 4-5, we leave some shots. But what's gonna, again, most likely happen? He's just gonna enter, 4-2, 4-3, 5-1, 5-2, whatever. Well, then, same as before, we can roll something like 6-2, 5-1, where we can just make some kind of point closer to home and get home safely afterwards. Or, well, we can roll 4-3 and just get this checker home safe. Yep, so this is it. This is the right option. Second option, it's pretty close. I mean, tough to say or tough to decide over the board what's best. This is, for example, cannot be really explained, as there's just so many ways to balance. I mean, it can be explained, but it probably cannot be found. Like, you may find this, I mean, I did play this actually, but you cannot be 100% certain with this move, I would say. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching and have a good day.
If you enjoy learning about backgammon, watching backgammon, we upload videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss any of our content. And remember, when you think there is nothing else coming up, there's always something coming up.